When I was petitioning in 2004 to get a particular axe the tax issue on the ballot in Nevada, 2 years prior to that, I'd almost, I'd almost been arrested at the Department of Motor Vehicles for petitioning there for marriage between a man and a woman. And I waited for them. They brought the paddy wagon, but they didn't arrest me that year. And so we got the law changed in the state of Nevada, which provided that you can petition on public property. You know, they say you have a right to petition, but the problem is you can't do it on public or private property. So do you really have a right? This is the issue, and it has been an issue, and Nick knows this very well. And my claim to fame is, Nick, I taught him how to petition.
You came in 96, Illinois, and I was a novice, and I never knew anything about it. But I was petitioning before that, but he taught me how to think. Because thinking is very important. People want to help us. Just ask me, will you please help us? That's all it is.
Yeah. That's right. So anyway, I knew what the law was because I had helped at the Nevada State Legislature to craft the law that provided that people could petition on public property, like places like the DMV. So when my people began to be thrown off the bus depot where they were petitioning, I said, I'll take care of it. So I called them and said, I'm on my way. I'm giving you notice as required by the state law. And I will be there to petition. They said, oh no, you have to fill out our paperwork. I said, no, that's not in the state law. I knew what the state law was. I've been a citizen lobbyist at the state legislature for many, many years. In fact, my entire adult life. And so I went there to petition with my son and someone that was there to keep track of what we did. Within 5 minutes, the police were there. They handcuffed us. They threw us in a paddy wagon and hauled us off to jail. Now, I would mention to you that when you're usually petitioning, it's not wise to get arrested. If you can avoid it, you won't have to spend that time in jail. But let me tell you that in America, he has rights who dares to assert them. So if we do not assert our right, that we have a right to freedom of speech, and we have a right to petition, it will be like it was in Nevada, that until this went all the way to the Nevada Supreme Court, and I was exonerated. Until that happened, we essentially didn't have a right at the DMV, or at the bus depot, or at the university to petition. So you need to keep that in mind, because if you have a right, like to petition, and you don't have anywhere to do it, it's a meaningless right. And if you aren't willing to challenge that. Now, many times I've been threatened to be arrested, I avoided that for different reasons. Either I went somewhere else, or I came back later, or something else. So I don't encourage you to get arrested, but in this case, we were making a point, and I was asserting my right. So what are some of the important things? How many of you have ever gone out and collected signatures? Great, that's wonderful. How many of you have been in charge of other people getting signatures? Okay. How many of you have paid for people to get signatures? Okay, so the way we get on the ballot in almost every state is that we have to petition. Now this is a blessing. It's not a curse, it's a blessing. Because what happens when we go out and petition? In 1992, Nevada got on the ballot. We had to have over 10,000 signatures. We actually got 17,000 signatures. We paid for it ourselves. Most of it was done by volunteers. Nobody got arrested that year, and we were successful in getting on the ballot. And after that, we've stayed on the ballot every year. But what are and then one year, I want to tell you about this particular experience that I had. I got the prize for getting the most signatures of any woman in the state of Nevada. But what did that experience of our people going out and talking to others and getting signatures do? It helped to build our party. That is an exercise that helps to build your party. Just like running for office, you go out and talk to people, you build a constituency, and it helps to build your party. So it's a blessing, not a curse, even though it's hard. Anything worth doing is usually hard. So when you go out to petition, one of the things you have to know is usually you're saying too much. The less you say, the better. When you're petitioning, less is more. Okay? Because you only have a few seconds to get somebody's attention. So there's probably many ways to do this that are all good, But when I was the National Ballot Access Coordinator, I would call people and I would talk to them on how to do it. And then I would call back in a week and say, how have you done? Well, we haven't done very well, this and that and the other. I said, how did you petition? And then they would tell me, I said, well, you didn't do what I said, did you? No. Because they think they knew better. But I'd done thousands, tens of thousands of petition signatures I'd gathered. And so when I do it, and I don't like to be behind something. So see, I'm not behind this podium here. So when I'm petitioning, I'm out meeting the public. I'm not behind a desk. Now, if you're doing a gun show or if you're doing the state fair, you might have to be behind something. But that limits your ability to do it. So when you're going out to do it, and you might have several petition boards with you. In my state, we have to do them by county. So you might have to have several different counties on your board and have a different sheet for each county because they have to go there to be checked. So all those things you have to do, and you might have some literature in your pocket about the Constitution Party. But what's your main objective when you go out to petition? Get a signature. You're not trying to sign somebody up to be a member of the Howard Phillips Society or give them the whole copy of the Constitution Party platform, are you? Your objective is to get a signature. Now, I've been a member of Legal Forum almost as long as I've been in this party. And Phyllis used to say, Phyllis Laffey said, we let people vote for us for the reason of their choice. Now, we don't care what their reason is as long as they sign on the dotted line, do we? So we're not checking out why if they're purists and they're going to sign for us for the right reason. We don't care about that. What we care about is getting that signature. So the first thing I do when I approach somebody is I say, and I'm out in the parking lot. And usually I talk to them when they're coming out. Why do I do that? Because they aren't going in to complain about me. When they're coming out, they're not going to go back in and complain that I'm there. So I'm talking to people as they're loading their groceries in the back of their car. And so when I talk to them, I say, are you registered to vote? Why? Because I got to have registered voters. And if they aren't registered, what am I saying? Next. So every time you're thinking in your mind, okay, how many am I going to get? Okay, so next. So if this person's registered to vote, are you registered to vote? Would you sign my petition to let an independent party on the ballot? Now, they don't know what the Constitution Party is. And if you have to explain it to them, you've already lost their signature. Now, if they have questions, then I'll explain it to them. Yes, this is our party, the Constitution Party. We believe in the Constitution, don't you? That's pretty easy, isn't it? You don't have to go into the platform. So, would you let an independent party on the ballot? Would you like to have somebody else to vote for? Yes, great. Print your name right here. I stop talking at that point. If they said yes, I don't want to give them any reason to say no, do I? No. Print your name here, and I'm pointing, okay? Half of them don't have their glasses on. Print your name right here. Put your signature, like you registered to vote, right here. Put your address, where you registered to vote, right here. You know, whatever else. And I'm pointing. Because one of the problems we have is we get a lot of petitions, and they're filled out wrong. And then those names are what? They're no good. So we want to have a real high percentage of good signatures. So you got to watch these people because they're, you know, they're like kids. Unless you're telling them what to do, they don't get it done right. And you have to point. Okay, right here, print your name, sign your name, where you're registered, the date, whatever you need. So that's one of the things you need to remember. You have to be in charge of getting the right information. And in my state, you used to be able to fill in the date or something else. Now we can't. If we do that, we're in trouble. When you're setting up a petition campaign, you need to check the laws in your state. Now in my state, on the Secretary of State's website, they have all the petition rules there. And you can go and do that. They didn't used to do that, but now they do. And so you can find out what those are. And you need to be an expert in what those are. You may have to have them notarized. I was a notary for many years, so when we could notarize our petitions, then we had somebody else that could notarize mine. So we did that. When we started doing our petition in Nevada to get on the ballot, every week we had a call, and that was in 1992, so we didn't have all the technology we have now. We would just have a call. How many signatures did they get down in Las Vegas? Because that's the largest population. How many signatures did we get up in the Reno area? And so we had a thermometer, and we were raising the thermometer to see how far we were going to get. And every week we were checking. And no signature counts until what? It's turned in. Nobody's promise makes any difference. It has to be there. You have to be able to see it, that it's there and it's done correctly. Otherwise, it doesn't count. The other thing that is important is security. Years ago, when George Wallace, my brother Dan Hansen had started the party, and they were getting signatures to get George Wallace on the ballot. Margie Dyer took 5,000 signatures and burned them up. She got angry. So you have to have ballot you have to have security for your petitions. You can't just leave them laying around wherever for somebody to pick them up. So that's something important we learned at that point in time, that you have to have security. Now, whatever the rules are in your state for turning them in, you have to follow those rules. So in our state, we had to turn them in every county. We only have 17 counties, but we had to have someone in each county that knew what they were doing, and they were poached, and so we could get them turned in, and we had to turn them in all on the same day. So we had all of our people ready to turn them in all on the same day. So it takes a certain amount of coordination, doesn't it? And you have to be in touch with those people, and you have to talk to them. And you have to, not just on Facebook, you have to actually see what they've done, if they actually have those petitions. Because people will tell you anything. Oh yeah, I have good intentions going out. Now, one of the biggest problems of getting signatures is that people don't like to be rejected. They don't like to have somebody tell them no. Who likes for people to say no to them when they want an answer? Oh, you do. Okay. So, nobody really likes to get rejected, do they? That's why a lot of people aren't salesmen. When Howard Phillips sent me over to Utah, before our great Frank was there, to get us on the ballot, we had 3 days to get 1,000 signatures. So I left my kids with my mother, and I took my husband, and we went over to Salt Lake to get those 1,000 signatures. So we started out at the DMV, my husband and I, and he's a salesman, so he's not afraid to talk to anybody. And so we started. He hadn't petitioned with me before, but I showed him how to do it, and he was great. So we went to the Department of Motor Vehicles, and we were getting 30 an hour. Now that's a lot to get an hour. How many of you got 10 an hour? Yeah. How many of you got 20 an hour? Yeah. Fewer. How many of you got 30 an hour? How many have got 40 an hour? Okay. So Nick is the only one that's going to defeat all of us. I have got 40 an hour and more, but most of us don't do that. We don't have wings on our feet like Nick, but we can do more than we're doing. Now, what's important so that you can get 20, 10, 30 an hour? What's important? You have to be at a place where there's lots of people, don't you? You have to choose some place where there's a lot of people. So it might be the parade route before the parade comes marching by that you can go to every person that's along there. It might be, I went to a convention one time and people were standing out in line, and I started getting their signatures until they told me the cops were coming. I said, okay, well, we'll go somewhere else for now, come back later, which I've often done that when they've kicked me off someplace. I go back later when some other manager's on. So you have to find a place that has a lot of traffic. So we started out at the DMV, and then we went to the Walmart. And at Walmart, we were both getting 40 an hour. Well, in 3 days, we got over our 1,000 signatures, and we were able to turn them in and get them on the ballot. So what happened? Every time somebody said no to me, what did I do? Oh my gosh, I'm rejected. Next. Next. Okay? So every time I'm doing next, I'm getting closer to the one that's going to say yes. Okay? So I don't worry about those no's. So if somebody wants to argue with me, what do I do? Oh, have a very nice day. Next. I don't spend 5 minutes talking to them, because I could get two or three or four signatures in that time, depending on the numbers of people that are there. Couldn't I? I could. And so I'm not wasting my time on this person. Now, if there's somebody that is interested in the party, and I didn't bring it up here, if they're really interested, I have little cards. They're 3x5 cards, and they have on their name, address, email, phone number. And I say, oh my gosh, you're interested in the party? Well, would you please fill this out and we'll get in touch with you? Because they probably don't have a business card or anything else. So I get them to write that down. I do that when I'm working at the legislature as well, anybody that's interested. And that way, I can contact them. So if you have somebody like that, you can give them a brochure about the party, and you can get their name, and you can follow up. But you don't spend 10 minutes talking to that person. Why? Because you could get a bunch more signatures. Now, I don't send people that haven't gotten signatures out by themselves. Why? Because people don't like to get rejected. You know, they feel like when people say no, they're saying they're rejecting that person. It has nothing to do with that, of course, and we have to remember to tell them that. It has to do with people don't want to sign anything, or maybe they're a communist. So anyway, I think it's really important for us to take somebody by the hand when we're going to go and get signatures and teach them how to do it, and don't send them out on their own. Now, you might have to go in one situation I was in. We had a county where we had to get signatures. It's a very small county, Story County, where Virginia City is. They have three population zones, and we had to go to all these three different places. And the only place to go in one of them was door to door. That's slow getting signatures. But we were able to get about 10 an hour doing that. So there are different circumstances. So let me tell you what. Look at petitioning as a wonderful opportunity to build the party, to build your volunteers, and to begin a new day for your party in the state. And if you have questions about petitioning, if you need help, you can call me on the phone, you can call Nick, you can call other people that are experienced with petitioning, because it's very difficult nowadays to get people to do it as volunteers, but all of us were volunteers when we did it. None of us were paid. And you can do it with volunteers if you have camaraderie, if you teach people, if you have events where you go out with people, and you can be successful in doing this petitioning. Just remember, next. Thank you.